And I think that's part of what Jesus was trying to say in the parable. And that's what was being said when Paul said, when someone's saved, in other words, the Spirit comes in and they're a new creation. They're a new creature. Even though the outer expression, even though the outer view, even though the way they look, and sometimes even the way they act, for a while at least, is no different. Because God begins in here with the heart and begins to mold and make and remake that person. Well, I was over in Franklin County. Is that where Laurel's at? Thank you. I was up north of Laurel. I was enjoying the drive, all the curves and hills and hollers and woods, and you could hear guns shooting 24/7 over there. My kind of place. I love it. But I was going to make a visit and was there to see a family and pray with this young lady. And I knew she was in her, like, 44 years old. It seemed like there was a lot of folks that were 44 years old. I've told a couple other stories, I think. But wonderful, wonderful young lady. Belonged to a church over in Connersville. I don't know if you ever heard of it. It's a biker church. Anybody heard of that one? Yeah? I was so intrigued, I had to go check it out, and I was amazed. But so I was over there visiting with this family, this lady, and it was a day like today. The sky was clear, not a cloud in the sky hardly, or at least wasn't when I came in a while ago. It's Indiana, you know. It could change. But I heard this humongous rumble like thunder. And I thought, oh my goodness, as a storm came up, I had left my windows down. I was driving a Jeep at the time, a real one. Not the one I've got now. But I had a four-door Wrangler. But so I was concerned about that, and then some big knock on the door. And so one of the family members answered the door, and lo and behold, there was four huge men that walked in that door. And they had rode their Harleys. And they looked like Harley riders, you know. They had the chains, the leather, the tattoos, and everything, you know, like you see on TV once in a while, in some pretty rough cut shows. And I thought, oh my gosh. But they announced, we came to pray. I said, by all means, I'll just get out of the way. And so they did. They prayed. I guess my point is, inside, they were new creatures. They were being and serving Christ, even though the outer shell still looked like it did before. And of course, in some respects, there's no way they could change the outer shell. But I was fearful for a little while. I had the wrong perspective, the wrong view. But that's how God sees. And I'm so glad. Well, I think that may be a good place to stop. Let's pray. Father, for the day you've made, we thank you for it. Give us eyes to see again your will and your way and your work in the hearts of many. Help us to trust that you know what's going on, even though we can't see what's going on. Many times things look mighty rough, mighty tough. People look the same, rough and tough. But with you at work in their heart, and with them being a new creation in Christ Jesus, they're working for you. They're with us, not against us, just like you are. So you're always up to something. And for that, we thank you. So Lord, there was many illnesses mentioned. There are shut-ins in the bulletin. There's sickness along with joy and happiness in the lives of many graduates. A new door opening, which is fearful and scary. So give each one strength and open ears and open eyes to your path for them as you provide day by day in Christ Jesus, in whom we pray, who taught us these words. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Forgive us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor. And now we have an opportunity to give our tithes and gifts to Jesus and God. And our special offering this month is to Mahoning Valley Christian Service Camp.
Let us pray. Father, as we see things,
we cannot
pretend to know your nature. You are too big for our small minds to understand. We know, Lord, is that you love us despite our sinfulness. While we give thanks to you for our fathers,
we give our thanks to you, Father God,
that you forgive our sins through Jesus and guide us in holy living through your Spirit. Amen.
And now our closing hymn is "For the Fruit of All Creation," hymn number 379.
Father, today you reminded us that though things look rough and tough, there's more going on than meets the eye. So as we go today, help us to remember that you are with us, that you are working, that even though it looks bad all around, you as well are all around working good. The work of turning things around. And for that, Lord, we thank you. In and through Christ Jesus, in whom we pray. And amen.